안녕하세요. Hi everyone. This is Gia. Today we'll be making gochujang jjigae. This is a stew that I often make during summer when potatoes and zucchini are abundant. Gochujang adds not only spicy, but also it gives a very nice, deep, robust flavor to this stew. If you like spicy stew, I'm sure you're gonna love this dish. Okay, here are the ingredients that we'll be using to make gochujang jjigae. Let's start from cutting tofu. Let's cut everything in big bite-sized pieces. And then potato. I'm using medium-sized potato today. And then we're going to cut them in big chunks. Let's put the potatoes in water because it has lots of starch. Remove a little bit of starch and prevent from browning. And then we're going to cut the onion. I think it's a little small, so if you're using large, I recommend to use only half. Also, cut them in big chunks. And this is zucchini. Looks a little bit different, but it's zucchini. Let's slice the green onion. I'm using one stalk of green onion. So diagonally slice it. And we'll be using one chili. This is not so spicy. We're using this more for color and garnish. So just I'm using half of the chili, thinly sliced. I think half would be enough. So let's just save this for later. And the garlic. Just chop 2 cloves of garlic. And the pork. We're using pork shoulder. And the shoulder part of the pork is the ideal part of the pork for stews. It's not so fatty and it's not so tough or lean. So I want this stew a little rustic. So the size is, you don't have to cut this too small. Preheat the pot with a little bit of oil. We're using sesame oil and this is grapeseed oil. Any vegetable oil works for this stew. And add pork to the pot. So the pot is heated over medium heat. To higher the smoking point, it's good to use the sesame oil and the vegetable oil mixed together. Now, we're going to add water. And we're going to bring this to a boil. Once it's boiling, we're going to remove the foam. So skim off. Okay, once the stock gets to a boil, then we can add the firm vegetables like potato, zucchini, and onion. Let's put everything, stir in to the pot, and then we're going to bring this to a boil again. In the meantime, we want to make a sauce. We're going to combine gochujang and doenjang, Korean soybean paste. And this is light soy sauce. Make sure you're using soup soy sauce, light soy sauce, because regular dark soy sauce makes the stew sweet. The stew is boiling, so let's add this. And gently mix. The zucchini, potato, and the onion looks half cooked. It's not fully cooked, so it's gonna take another 3 minutes or so. Gochujang is a fermented red chili paste. Doenjang is a fermented soybean paste. So by mixing those two ingredients, the traditional sauce gives a very nice flavor and taste. Now we want to add tofu, tofu to the stew. So make sure they are submerged in the liquid. And we also want to add the red chili and chopped sliced green onion on the top. And a little bit of garlic to it. And there's one more ingredient left, gochugaru, Korean chili flakes. To just add just a little bit of it, reduce the heat. And we're going to cook until the potato, zucchini, everything is fully cooked. It's going to take about 5 minutes. Let's check if the potatoes and all the vegetables are fully cooked. It easily breaks. It's done. So we're going to turn off the heat. Let's put this in a bowl. So make sure this is gochujang jjigae. Jjigae means stew. So it's not a soup. So it shouldn't be too much stock, too liquidy. Smells wonderful. If you like kimchi jjigae, kimchi stew, or sundubu stew, like spicy stews, you're gonna love it. Thank you for watching. See you next time.